2.0 marks the launch of the Bitcoin chain, which will run using proof of stake to coordinate block creation and finalization. Let's take a look into some key concepts of Ethereum 2.0 proof of stake. Time on the Bitcoin chain is fixed relative to proof of work Ethereum, where block times are approximate. The smallest unit of time is a slot. A slot lasts 12 seconds, and a block can be created in each slot. An epoch lasting 6.4 minutes is made of 32 slots. The first slot of each epoch is a checkpoint. A checkpoint is when blocks from prior epochs can become finalized. While proof of work had miners, the Bitcoin chain will have validators, who conduct two main duties for the network. For each slot, one validator gets pseudo-randomly selected to submit a block. While the selector validator is incentivized to create a block, it can also miss that opportunity. In this case, the system will proceed without a block for that slot. Other validators are sorted into committees and will submit attestations once every epoch. Attestations are votes on what the most recent block is and whether prior checkpoints are valid. These votes help finalize blocks, making them forever irreversible. The Bitcoin chain will have economic incentives to make sure validators are actively participating in securing the network. Validators who submit blocks and attestations honestly will be rewarded for their work with new ETH. The reward rate will vary from 2% to 22% depending on how much ETH is being staked on the network. However, if validators are offline for a sustained period of time, they will be penalized by being deducted ETH. Since connectivity can be an issue for people running validators from home, the penalty for being offline is not extreme, and being online more than 50% of the time should net a positive reward. Finally, validators who act maliciously will be slashed. These validators will have their ETH deducted by a substantive amount and will also be kicked out of the active validator set. Slashable behavior threatens the security of the network, hence why they have severe consequences. Next up, we will look into the migration to the Bitcoin chain and its launch.